Hi, my name is Adrian Monza, and I'm a Principal Enterprise Account Engineer at AWS. Today, I want to talk to you about declarative policies, a new type of organizational policy that gives you the ability to declare and enforce desired security configurations at scale across your AWS organization. So what do customers want? First, customers tell us they want tools that make enforcing security requirements simple, so they can focus their time on delivering functionality that delights their customers. Next, customers emphasize they need solutions that scale with them across tens, hundreds, or thousands of accounts and resources. Regardless of whether they have a small organization or the largest of enterprises, customers want to enforce security configurations consistently and have peace of mind that the configuration they set is continuously enforced across all their AWS accounts. And at the same time, that solution must be flexible. Customer organizations are dynamic, and whether it's applying a new security policy to an existing workload or deploying a new application or use case, our customers stress the importance of flexibility. They need to evaluate the impact of new policies on existing resources before enforcing that policy, and they need the ability to allow exceptions for those new and unique use cases. And finally, customers challenge us to provide them with solutions that improve developers' productivity and happiness, or developers too. And we thought, what would we want our experience to be if our action or API request was blocked due to a security requirement? We thought about how great it would be to get a customized error message that provided organization-specific information, like a link to a wiki for more information, or maybe to a ticketing system to request an exception. So we built it in. We heard what customers want, and at reInvent 2024, we launched a new AWS organizations management policy type called Declarative Policies to meet these needs. As the name suggests, Declarative Policies allows you to declare and enforce a configuration for specific AWS services. With Declarative Policies, customers can define desired configuration outcomes using English-like statements with a few simple clicks or commands. They're simple and fast to set up. The configuration defined in the Declarative Policy is always maintained, even when AWS services introduce new APIs, new accounts are added to an organization, or new principles and resources get created. Non-compliant actions fail regardless of whether they were invoked by a principal or by an AWS service using a service-linked role. And finally, declarative policies are transparent. They support customizable error messages that allow administrators to redirect end users to internal wiki pages and other resources, reducing end user frustration. So let's see it in action. To enable declarative policies, we first need to log into the management account for our organization, go to the organization's portion of the console, select Policies, then click on the link for Declarative Policies for EC2, and click on the button to enable Declarative Policies for EC2. Now that we've enabled Declarative Policies as a new policy type, let's create our first policy. So I'll click on the Create Policy button. And let's start by creating a policy that blocks EBS public snapshots. Now, I'm not very creative when it comes to naming, so I'm going to call it Block Public EBS Snapshots, because we don't want any snapshots to be public. We'll click on where it says Choose Service Attribute in the Visual Editor, and click on the link, click on the selection for Snapshot Block Public Access. And this controls whether or not EBS snapshots can be publicly accessible. I'm going to click on the checkbox to block public access, and I have the option to either block all new public sharing, and with that, all of my accounts or any accounts that I apply this policy to won't be allowed to share new snapshots, to make new snapshots public, but any existing ones that are already public would remain public. Alternatively, I can block all public sharing, and that will take any existing public snapshots and that will change them to become private snapshots. The snapshots themselves aren't removed, but they're no longer publicly accessible. They're private snapshots. In this case, I want to block all public sharing. And let's add a custom error message so that our developers know what we're doing and why we're doing it. And we'll say EBS public snapshots are not permitted. And let's give them a wiki to go to. See https wiki.example.com/no-public-snapshots. And now we've created our policy and a custom error message to help developers if they have questions. So I'm going to go click on the link to block public EBS snapshots, and I'm going to go here to where it says targets. Because I've created the policy, now I have to apply it to accounts. So I'm going to click on attach, and I have the option to attach this policy to the root of my organization, to different OUs in my organization, or to specific accounts in my organization. In this case, I want this to be applied everywhere. I don't want public snapshots anywhere in my organization, so I'm going to apply it to the root. And I'm going to attach the policy. And just like that, I've taken all of my public snapshots, I've converted them, they are now private snapshots, and none of the accounts in my organization will be able to accidentally make an EBS snapshot public. It's a really important security control that I've enabled it with just a couple of clicks. That was pretty quick and straightforward. So let's build another one together. Now, one of my customers has a centralized team that produces AMIs for the organization. The AMIs are pre-configured with their security settings and software agents, and it gives the development teams a consistent starting point from which to develop their systems. Now, my customer wants their developers to only use AMIs produced by that centralized team, and they asked me how I could help them implement that requirement. So let's do that together and help my customer. So I'm creating a new declarative policy for EC2, and let's call this one only use allowed AMIs. Now this time we're going to scroll down to the visual editor, and instead of snapshot block public access, we're going to choose the allowed image settings. Now I'm going to set it to enabled. There's also an audit mode. If you enable audit mode and apply it to an account, what happens is that the account can then see which images are permitted and which images are not permitted. It doesn't block them from launching anything, so you don't stop them from doing anything, but it gives them a visual representation so that they know what's allowed, what's not allowed. It's really great for applying a policy like this to a new account or to a new team. So in this case, I'm going to set it to enabled. Now I have to, now that I'm requiring my accounts to use a particular images from a particular location, I have to add which locations are allowed. So I'm going to add a new AMI provider. I can either say Amazon, and that will allow my accounts to launch images from Amazon and other verified providers, the AWS marketplace, so they can launch images provided through the marketplace, backup vault, so they can launch images from prior snapshots that are in AWS backup vaults, or an Amazon account number, like the account number for my centralized image team. In this case, I'm going to use that account number for my centralized image team. 1, 2, 6, 9, 0, 1. There we go. And just like before, let's add a custom error message to help out my developers. And we're going to say only use images from the centralized team. And just like before, we'll put in a wiki address for them. .com, and we'll call it approved images. Now I've created the policy, and just like before, we'll go into the policy, we'll set the target, and we'll attach it. Now in this case, I'm only going to attach it to the workload OU because this policy really only applies to my development teams. So I'm going to attach it, and just like that, I've set a requirement that my development teams can only use AMIs from my approved centralized imaging team. If I wanted to restrict it differently to only allow images from the marketplace, or if I only wanted to allow images from Amazon and other verified providers, I could do that with just a few simple clicks. Let's recap. Our guidance to customers is simple. If the configuration you're trying to enforce is available as a service attribute in declarative policies, use declarative policies. But why is that? We have three reasons why we think customers should use declarative policies. First, as you saw in my demonstration, declarative policies are simple to set up and configure. It only took us a couple of minutes and a few clicks in the console to configure and apply a declarative policy to our organization. Second, the configuration is always maintained. Even when services add new features, new APIs, or if I added new resources, the configuration is consistently applied. And third, you can set custom error messages to redirect your users to an internal wiki or ticketing system, giving them a clear path forward. Declarative policies give you a simple way to define your desired configuration outcomes, enforce them at scale, and ensure they're always true. To learn more, you can visit the What's New page introducing declarative policies, read the AWS News blog post on declarative policies, or read the documentation in the AWS Organizations User's Guide. I'm Adrian Monza. Now let's go build.